Parker, ever hear of Planet of the Apes?
The movie or the planet?
The brand new multi-million dollar musical. And you are starring as the human.
It's the part I was born to play, baby!
What's up, YouTube? You are watching the Skynet Gen Network, and today we're going to be unboxing Everything Apes. That's right, you heard me, we're unboxing Everything Apes. So we'll be unboxing Planet of the Apes Legacy Collection, Rise of the Planet of the Apes, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, and finally, Planet of the Apes TV series. So let's get started with Planet of the Apes Legacy Collection. This has the five original Planet of the Apes movies in Blu-ray format. This is what it looks like. There's the spine. Here's the back. It's got a slip cover. Here's what it looks like. Pretty much the same exact thing on the back, just like on the slip cover. It's about the same size as a regular Blu-ray box. It's a little bit heavier because, again, there are five discs in here. And this is what it looks like on the inside. So you got Planet of the Apes. Beneath the Planet of the Apes. Escape from the Planet of the Apes. Conquest of the Planet of the Apes and Battle of the Planet of the Apes. So they look exactly alike. They're the same. And in fact, there's another collection. If you buy the... I forget what it's called, but there's another collection where it's like it's a Caesar's head. And then when you open up his head, it has like all of the movies. All eight movies. It includes the Tim Burton movie and the new ones. The Rise of the Planet of the Apes and Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. I don't remember how much it costs, but yeah. The discs look exactly the same. In that collection, they're all red and they look like this. So, you know, at the time I bought this, that didn't even exist. So whatever. This one actually came out in 2014. It is, so I got it for like $30, but I think the price has dropped now. It's been a year now, so it's like probably $25. I've seen it for $20 on Amazon and Best Buy. So yeah, it's pretty, for five movies, it's a pretty good price. So let me just actually show you what it looks like on the TV behind me, and then we could look at what are some of the special features it has, what do the menus look like, you know, stuff like that. And on the first disc, I'll maybe play the first couple of scenes to just see what the quality is. I mean, this isn't really a review, but I just want to see for myself what the quality looks like, because I originally saw these movies on VHS. So I just want to see what has changed, how it will look on the big screen at home. So let's just see what it looks like.
Planet of the Apes, and all among the wealth of supplements that lie herein are the evolution of the apes in which we celebrated the origins of the great story, the impact of the apes in which our story was made known to the world, and the science of the apes, which gave valuable knowledge for playing of the adventure game Beyond the Forbidden Zone, and a lost document from the sub-ape humans was also excavated. Told of their misguided voyages through space in the distant past. Now go forth to that which awaits.
So it's got a nice little intro by Zaius. That's pretty nice. So now let's see what the menu looks like. Okay. Also see what special features it has, if it has any. I think it says bonus special features on the box. So this is the menu. Not bad. We have special features. So we have commentary by Roddy McDowell, commentary by composer, commentary by the author of the book, Planet of the Apes as American Myth. Okay, Science of the Apes bonus view, Beyond the Forbidden Zone adventure game. A public service announcement from ANSA. Evolution of the Apes. Impact of the Apes. Behind the Planet of the Apes documentary. Behind the Planet of the Apes promo. The Archives of the Apes. The Galleries of the Apes. And then D-Box Mastering Motion, which I'm not really sure what that is. So yeah, so we got quite a few special features on this disc. Let's now check. Let's just briefly look at the quality. I just chose a random scene. Thank you. quality looks pretty good from what I can tell. It's got a lot of special features, so this is a star. Looks pretty good for this disc at least. We'll see what the other discs look like. Next is Beneath the Planet of the Apes. The journal Beneath the Planet of the Apes was not considered to be that great of a movie, so I'm just curious to see what kind of special features we get on that movie, or for all these other movies, which don't live up to the first one, but they're still, you know, they're still classics, and I personally still enjoy watching each and every one of them. Just curious to see what kind of special features they add, if there is any. That'd be great if they have as many special features on each disc as they do with, as they had with the first disc. As it says on the box, plus hours of Out of This World Blu-ray extras. I'm assuming it's on all the discs, not just one. So we're about to find out. And also, see if the menus look different.
And it came to pass that another document was included that told of the tribulations involved in doing a further chapter of the Apes saga. And the question remained, would the public come to the sequel, anointing it with approval and success?
So another Zaius introduction. We got a new menu. Style is similar, but we do have a new menu. The image in the background. Special features. So from Alpha to Omega, building a sequel. Theatrical trailer, galleries. And that's pretty much it. So there's only three special features on this thing, so not a whole lot on this one. So now we move on to the next one. Which will be Escape from the Planet of the Apes. Personally, I was not a huge fan of that movie. I mean, I still like the series, but I thought that one was the worst one. I mean, it wasn't the worst movie. It was better than Battle of the Planet of the Apes. I enjoyed Battle of the Planet of the Apes a little bit better, even though it was worse. Because the third movie, Zero, just pissed me off, and then the third one just seemed like such a comedy. If you did not see the first movie, the second movie, or any of the other movies, and you just strictly go to the third movie, you think you're watching a comedy. You know, it's the first 2 minutes of the movie. You watch the movie, right? You see two astronauts coming onto the surface of the beach. They take off their helmets, and it's freaking apes. I mean, if you hadn't seen any of the other movies, never even heard of it, you're thinking this is a comedy. And then outside of that, just the fact that it seemed like such a comedy, some of the characters were just pissing me off. Like, Zero pissed me off, you know. One minute they're trying to help the humans, they're trying to avoid this, the future that lies ahead of them with the apes and the humans. And, you know, next thing you know, the Zero's talking to the apes, trying to teach it English. Like, do you not know what's going to happen? Like, why are you trying to teach the ape how to talk? I mean, maybe it's beneficial to her, but anyway, here. This So anyway, I was saying that Zero just pissed me off in that third movie, and, you know, that's why I didn't like it that much. She turned into a real B-I-T-C-H in that movie, and I just hated it. I was like, so I wasn't really too upset that she died. So, special features. The secret behind the escape. I guess a documentary. Escape from the Planet of the Apes by Don Taylor. Theatrical trailer. Advertising gallery. Behind the scenes gallery. D-Box mastering. Yeah, so a little bit more special features, but still not as much as the first one. But the third movie was technically better than the second one. I just like the second one better than the third one, and I like pretty much all of them better than the third one. Even though the third one was not a bad movie, if you look at it as a whole, but it was one of my least favorite, like I said, even though I still enjoy watching the movie. So with that, we move on to the next one, which will be Conquest of the Planet of the Apes. Conquest. Which resembles, so Conquest of the Planet of the Apes kind of resembles Rise of the Planet of the Apes. So those of you who have not seen Conquest of the Planet of the Apes, I actually like Conquest of the Planet of the Apes better than Rise of the Planet of the Apes. Even though people are going to say, how is that even possible? How do you like Conquest of the Planet of the Apes better than Rise of the Planet of the Apes? I don't know, I just liked it better. I don't know. I just like the original movies, I guess. I don't know. Even though I have to say Dawn of the Planet of the Apes was a pretty good movie. It's like my second favorite Planet of the Apes movie. I don't think anything is going to beat the original. You know, effects. You know, yeah, that's better, there's more action, I guess, there's more effects and everything, but can't beat the first one. So we're about to see this one, how many special features they're going to add on this one. I think the reception of the fourth movie was still better than the second one, so there should be more special features on here than the second one, I'm assuming, if that's how they're going to do it. See what they're gonna do. Is they're saying that they edited a lot of stuff out, like violence and stuff in the theatrical version, so are they gonna give us like two different versions or a new version, or let's see what they do. Yeah, so there you have the theatrical version, and then they have the unrated version. So the unrated version is gonna have the more violence and stuff that the theatrical version did not have. So yeah. Unrated version. Let's see that one. Special features. Theatrical version is one of the special features. Riots and Revolutions Confronting the Times. A Look Behind the Planet of the Apes, 1972. Another documentary from J. Lee Thompson, Conquest of the Planet of the Apes. Theatrical trailer, galleries, and D-Box mastering motion, which I still don't know what that is. Let's see what it is. I'm just curious what this D-Box mastering thing is. It's in every single disc as special features. Probably gonna need internet or something to work. What is this? See the film here? The film? No. Film the film with D-Box. Okay, so just, yeah, some ads to visit their site. Nothing really. So yeah, they have a unrated version. I don't know if the VHS version that I saw was the unrated version, or the theatrical version, so I'm going to have to watch it and see. I didn't know they made two of them. I didn't know that they made an unrated version of this movie. It's going to be definitely interesting to watch. The differences between the two. Just out of curiosity. Yeah, The Conquest of the Planet of the Apes is rated PG. That's weird. All the other ones are rated G. Conquest of the Planet of the Apes is the only one that's rated PG. So I'm assuming the... Does that count as the... Oh, wait. Plus, there's the unrated version. So that must be the PG-13, I guess. One. And Conquest of the Planet of the Apes, on the box, it says there's an unrated version of it, too. So we're about to see that one. So we move on to Battle of the Planet of the Apes. See if this one has the unrated versions again. There wasn't a whole lot of, I mean, there was violence, but, oh yeah, there was violence, actually, yeah, there was. I mean, obviously there was violence, but, let's see what kind of violence. It says there's an unrated version of it, so. I guess, I'm guessing it's going to be like the fourth movie. They're going to let you choose between the theatrical trailer, the theatrical version and the unrated version. So, let's see this. I'm assuming there's going to be a Zaius introduction as well. I mean, that'd be really weird if it didn't have a Zaius introduction. So we're giving, so there is, it's not an, it doesn't say unrated version, it says extended version. It's the extended unrated version, I guess, because it says unrated on the box. So extended unrated version, you can choose that one, or you can watch the theatrical version. Let's go with the extended version. Special features. So play theatrical version. End of an epic, the final battle, theatrical trailer, galleries, and D-Box mastering motion. It's not a whole lot of special features, only, what is it? Let's see, galleries, that's one, end of an epic, two. So there's really only two special features outside of the theatrical version and the, I guess, commentary, or not even commentary, there is no commentary. So yeah, so this is a really nice collection for $25, I got it for $30, pretty nice collection, nice little intros that they do here, the menus look nice, you got nice, I mean, if you collect all of the special features that are on five of these discs, you got plenty, hours of bonus features, so, you know, for $20, $25, $30, just getting those five movies, I think, is worth it, and now you're getting this bonus features with this set is, you know, with the hours of bonus features is really great, and they even have the last two movies, they have unrated and extended versions of the original movies, so I'm maybe curious to see how much different they are from the original ones that I watched back on the VHS versions of it. Because I don't remember if they were unrated or not. I don't think so. I think they just made the theatrical versions and they made the VHS version. So it's going to be interesting to watch that. So now we move on to Rise of the Planet. Rise of the Planet of the Apes, which you got right here. This is the Blu-ray DVD digital copy. So I'm gonna unbox that right now. It's got a nice little slip cover. Take it off. That's what it looks like without the slip cover. There is another version of this. I got this for like $10 on Amazon, but I know for those of you who have Big Lots nearby, this thing is like $5. It's just the Blu-ray version. There's no DVD digital copy. It doesn't come with a slipcover, and the front cover looks different. But it's $5 Blu-ray, Rise of the Planet of the Apes. So if you're looking to get it, Big Lots probably the cheapest place you can get it. But again, it's only the Blu-ray version. It's not the DVD digital copy, and it does not come with a slipcover. So anyway, back to this one. Open it up. That's what it kind of looks like. Let's see, it's just the digital copy code. Yeah, so this is different from the original digital copy thing. Usually they give you a DVD digital copy or ultraviolet thing. There's a code on this thing, and that's the code you use when you go online. Here, I think it's a bit different. Here you get the Blu-ray, and here's the DVD digital copy. So I'm assuming that here it says it's DVD plus digital copy, so there's the movie is on here, plus I think when you put this, the digital DVD plus digital copy disc in your computer, it should probably either ask you, do you want to play the movie, or take you, open up a new window, which will ask you, maybe, if you want to copy this. I don't know. I think you have to have the disc in the computer when you go onto their website and enter the code. I'm not entirely certain. Otherwise, why would it have digital copy written on the DVD disc? It would just give you the code and that's it. So I'm not really sure what that is. Just look at the back of it real quick. Yeah, I'm assuming. I'm assuming that you put the DVD, digital copy DVD into your computer, you go onto their website, you copy the code onto the website, and I guess that's the software that's online on that website will burn the content from the DVD digital copy disc. I'm assuming. It's really weird. So let's just put this in the Blu-ray player so you guys see what it looks like, the menu and everything, special features. I'm hoping there's special features on this thing. I'm assuming there's special features on this thing. Again, this is what the disc looks like. Well, I hate what they did with the case in terms of on the inside. You see this stuff? I mean, I could punch a hole right through these things. It's really annoying how they decided to really make these cheap cases, these recyclable cases. It's really crappy. Yeah. They're lighter, but like if I were to stack like 10 DVDs on top of this, it would probably just like dent the whole thing. Because there's no protection. This case holds the discs, but it doesn't really protect it, you know? And this case is just, like, so bendable. I mean, easily break it. So, maybe trying to save money and make these cheap cases. Maybe that's why Blu-rays are starting to get a little bit cheaper than they used to be. Let's see.
just looks like. I think there's special features on this.
Yeah, there should. Yeah, there is special features.
But it looks like there's only special features on disc one, so they're assuming. Well, yeah, I mean, the digital copy disc only comes with this case, so the special features, they're gonna assume you're gonna watch on Blu-ray and not on DVD. So they're not gonna waste space and put it on DVD. Yeah. What is this? What is this? What is this nonsense? Take me to the menu. Gosh. All these questions. I swear, if I need another Blu-ray update, which wouldn't make sense at all because I updated it like a few weeks ago, a week ago, yeah. Unboxing the X-Men series, and all of a sudden, you know, Wolverine decided not to play because my Blu-ray player was outdated, so I had to update it. But this is a 2011 movie. There should be no reason why it shouldn't even work. So there is the menu. We got deleted scenes, Mythology of the Apes, The Genius of Andy Serkis, A New Generation of Apes, Scene Breakdown, Character Concept Art Gallery, Breaking Motion Capture Boundaries, Composing the Score with Patrick Doyle. Yeah, the music is great in this movie. The Great Apes, audio commentary with various people, theatrical trailers, sneak peek, not sure what that is. Sneak peek of what? The movie or the trailers for other movies? Deleted scenes. Yeah. So there's a lot of special features on this. And I like the fact that the special features, when you click on them, it doesn't go to a new page. You still have the trailer and the music in the background, and it lists the special features right here in a little new window. So I don't know if you can see it. It's right there. This is the special features. It also has live extras, which you need internet access for those live extras. My Blu-ray player does not have Wi-Fi, so it wouldn't work. So that's Rise of the Planet of the Apes. It looks pretty good. I like the fact that it has a lot of extras on it. And it's got a really nice soundtrack, and it's going to have a documentary on just the soundtrack alone. Patrick Doyle. So now let's see what this DVD digital copy thing looks like.
See, it says DVD. Yeah, DVD digital copy. I'm assuming
that there's a DVD on this DVD, that they have the DVD movie on there, and you can watch it on your Blu-ray, not just your computer. Because I've never seen them do that before. Usually they just give you a code. There's no disc. So let's see what this looks like. So the menu looks the same. Yeah, the menu's the same. So you got play, setup, scenes. There's no extras. So if you want to watch the extras, it's on the Blu-ray version. It's on the Blu-ray disc. I'm not saying that the DVD version doesn't have extras. This is the Blu-ray DVD. It comes in a set, so this DVD version is different from if you bought the movie on DVD. Because this DVD is exclusive for the Blu-ray version. Is this the digital copy disc or whatever? There's no digital copies option on here. So I'm guessing when you put on your into your computer, go on that website, it will, I guess, tell you what to do from there to burn it onto a device or whatever. I don't know. But pretty nice set. I do like the fact that there's extras on here. Quite a few. Wish they didn't cheap out on the case. I mean, but otherwise, pretty nice set. Definitely worth the $10. I like the slipcover. You know, look at those eyes. Yeah, I mean, I don't think you can see it on here, but on the case itself, the eyes are a little bit sparkly. They kind of glow a little bit. Looks pretty nice. So we now move on to Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. I got this one for like $11 on Amazon. So again, this is what it looks like. It's got this nice image of Caesar looking down on the people. Looks pretty nice, epic cover. What it looks like. Looks very similar to the slipcover. Got these sticker thingies off, you know, with one pull. Usually I like rip them and I have to like start peeling the thing off, and it's like finally I was able to get it off like with one pull. It's a miracle. It's a miracle of life. So, time to open this thing. This is what it looks like. Digital HD code. Yeah, so this one doesn't come with a DVD, but it does come with a code where you can download the movie you want to watch on your TV, computer, tablet, or smartphone. And it's got a little other promotions for these other movies. So for those of you who want the digital copy, it's up for grabs. So So whoever wants it, whoever sees this video and wants the digital copy, go after it, go get it, whatever. I'm not going to use it. I don't really need to watch it on, have it on my device. Just watch it at home. So this is what the Blu-ray disc looks like. I believe that this image was from the Rise of the Planet Apes. It's something that Caesar drew. It was in Rise of the Planet Apes, but they put the artwork on the Dawn of the Planet Apes Blu-ray disc. So again, cheap cases. These dang recycling crap. Don't like that they do that now. So let's see what that looks like. I'm hoping there's special features on this one. I'm assuming there would be. Yeah, there are. Oh yeah, there's a ton of special features. Looks like there's a ton. That's nice. This was my second favorite Planet of the Apes movie. I mean, I love the original ones, but I think this is like the second best one. Story-wise and how everything was shot, put together. And it's great to have Gary Oldman in this. Thought he was really great. As you've noticed, I was not unboxing Tim Burton's movie Planet of the Apes. I don't have that movie, and I don't think I'm gonna get it. I didn't really enjoy that movie, so sorry for anyone who liked that movie and wanted to see it being unboxed, but I didn't like it. I'm probably never gonna buy it on Blu-ray unless it's like really cheap. Just to complete my collection, I'll add it. This. So we're getting a sneak peek at Exodus. Didn't get really good reviews. I can't skip this crap? Well, that's just great. I can't even skip this. They're forcing me to watch Exodus. Sneak peek. I don't like that. I mean, I'm gonna watch this movie simply because Christian Bale's in it and, you know, it seems like a pretty good movie, especially if it's the director of Gladiator. It looks nice, like, costume design looks great. Christian Bale, I mean, is a pretty great actor. So I'm gonna watch this movie, but I heard some really bad reviews for this. Like, the ratings were just pretty bad. Sigourney Weaver's in this? The effects look pretty nice too, but I just heard that, you know, that this movie was just not good, despite that it looks pretty awesome. I'll eventually watch it. So I'm assuming that on the menu they were going to have a bonus sneak peek of Exodus and not just this, what we just saw. So on the box it says we have 2 hours of bonus features, so let's actually see these extras. So the menu looks pretty nice. Yes, I like the new thing that they did, because usually when they put extras, and you click on extras, it takes you to a new screen. Like, I want to have the trailer in the background, the music in the background. I like what they did. I like what they did with the extras, and they just put it in the corner, and you can just, like, flip through them. So we have deleted scenes. What else do we have? Journey to Dawn. Andy Serkis rediscovering Caesar. Humans and Apes, the cast of Dawn. The World of Dawn. The Ape Community. Movie Like an Ape, an Artist's Medium. So, Weta and Dawn. The Fight for a New Dawn. Audio commentary by Matt Reeves. A gallery. Theatrical trailers. Sneak peek of Exodus, Gods and Kings. Deleted scenes. Yeah, I already said that. So, yeah, quite a few special features. Really nice set, you know. Yeah. Really nice set. For, what, $11? Really good price. So that is the unboxing of that. Put it back in its original case. And now we move on to Planet of the Apes TV series. For any of you who are wondering where they can get Planet of the Apes TV series, just go on eBay. You can get it for about $20. There's 14 episodes in this series. It's a 1974 series, so right after the original series ended, they're like, how can we make more money off of this? And Fox is like, we have a solution. We're making a TV series. And, well, they're not making it. The series actually premiered in the UK, and it was pretty successful after one season. And And then on Fox, when they aired this in the U.S., when Fox aired this on the U.S., the ratings were just terrible. Halfway through the season, they aired half the season, and the show got canceled. So this DVD has all 14 episodes, even though it was canceled mid-season. But we can assume that Fox was planning to have a second season, or if not more seasons, as long as they had ratings, they were going to keep making, adding seasons onto this thing. And how we know that there's going to be more seasons? The ending of this is terrible. It ends, like, in the middle of nowhere. It just, the ending of this series, is just, it's not an ending. It's just like, oh, well, this episode ended. And it's like, well, what happens next? It doesn't really have an ending. It's, you know, so it just kind of just stops. As if, you can pretty much say, it just like, you would, but when you finish watching, you're like, well, where's the next episode? And then you find out, oh, this is it, that's it. You know, that's how I watched it when I watched it actually online. I was like, really? This is how it ends? It's not a great series by any means, but, you know, I had to get it for my collection, and Roddy McDowall is in here. He does a voice on here. He does the voice, and, so it's good to have someone talented like him to appear in this, and, yeah. So let me just do an unboxing of this real quick. I mean, this series is kind of cheesy after the first two episodes. It's pretty cheesy. And in fact, after the first two episodes, it kind of goes off topic. Like, this, the whole entire series, the first two episodes, they're looking for this disc that a computer that can read this disc so they can get back home. But after two episodes, they kind of just drop it, and it just becomes no longer these, you know, they're not searching for a way to get off to travel back to get to their home, to get home. They're wasting their time helping apes do random daily life chores and whatever, and it really goes, I mean, off topic, really. So this is what the front looks like, what the back looks like. And as you can see, actually you can't see, but there's a slip cover, and it comes with two little thin cases, which have two discs apiece in them. So, the first case, episodes 1 through 8. It's nice. It's actually not bad. I like the fact that they changed the discs. They're different. They look different. They're not just like one color or anything. So, let me see. Disc 1. Then we get disc 2. That's nice. So, four episodes per disc. And then we have the second one. Very similar. And here's what disc 3 looks like. Again, four episodes per disc. Or wait a minute. Four episodes on the third disc and two episodes on the fourth disc. I'm assuming there's no special features, which I would love to have some special features, but I can't imagine there would be special features. I don't think there are. Let me just check. Well, that sucks. There's no special features. I'm not seeing anything. Because again, this was just a way for Fox to make money. There wasn't really... I doubt that they're going to have special features on this. But it's a very cheesy, and for those of you who are wondering, well, where does this fit on the timeline? It doesn't really fit on a timeline. I mean, quite frankly, it really contradicts the series pretty badly. I mean, so it's for pretty much any of you who are Star Trek fans, if you watch the original Star Trek, any Star Trek series, or any of the movies associated with those, with that series, and then you go and watch the new Star Trek movies, they're completely different. In fact, I think the last Star Trek movie, I didn't see it, but I think it debunked the Wrath of Khan movie. You know, so I know there was a lot of people that were mad at that. So I haven't seen it, I'm probably not even going to bother watching the new Star Trek movies, but this thing kind of does the same thing with the Planet of the Apes movies, the original Planet of the Apes movies. This kind of debunks a lot of stuff, especially, you know, a minute into the series, you already see, like, some contradictions, because in the original series, there's no dogs, there's no cats, they were all killed off. In this series, dogs are alive. And we can assume the cats are alive, they just didn't show them, but dogs are alive, and it's really weird because, you know, how did the apes become pets then? If dogs are still alive, cats are probably still alive, why? I mean, so, and this is like set, I'm not sure how far apart this is set, but one other thing that's on here is that humans can talk. So in the original series, the original Planet of the Apes movie, humans can't talk. So when Bright Eyes, what's his name? That's what the apes call him. Becomes the starts talking. They're all surprised. Oh my gosh, he can talk! He can talk! In this series, humans can talk. It's kind of like the Tim Burton movie, but humans can talk. And it kind of ruins it a little bit. And the fact that there's dogs alive really messes things up. So quite frankly, this should be even worse than the Tim Burton movie. But for some reason, I thought the acting was pretty good on this thing. I love the fact that Roddy McDowell's in this. And it's pretty interesting to watch, despite the fact that it's kind of cheesy. There's a lot of flaws with it, and it kind of ends in the middle of nowhere, and it kind of goes off topic. So there's definitely a lot of problems with this, but I still wanted to get it, and watch a couple of scenes from it, and you can see for yourself if you would be interested in seeing this or not. Remember, this is a 1974 TV series, so don't expect anything too great, I guess. The effects aren't going to be all that great. From Canada, so I'm hoping that the region works in the U.S. I'm hoping that it works in the United States. You remember, when you're buying these things, there's regions, DVD regions. Blu-rays, I think it's region-free for all of them. For DVDs, you want to buy the right region that works where you're from. So I think Canada and the U.S. have the same region, I'm hoping. About to find out if it works. But I think they got this right from the VHS. There's a VHS version of this, and I think they just transferred it onto the DVD version. So there's no enhancements or anything, so I don't know if the quality's going to be all that great. So here's the main menu. We got the first episode, second episode, third episode, fourth episode. So let's watch the first episode. Okay, so it takes you to another menu when you click each episode. And you could do language selection, scene selection. What the hell is volume one main menu? Oh, volume one main menu, okay. Let's go to scene selection. Main menus. So I guess you can look at the introduction. This is their theme song, by the way. This is the TV show theme song. The intro, here is the episode, it writes the name, Escape from Tomorrow. So here, you're going to see this dog. Like, we're not even a minute into this, and we're already hearing dogs. Thank you. Here comes the spaceship. He's kind of like a rebel. He kind of does things behind the apes' backs. Well, pretty much all the other humans, they're all shivering in fear, and they're doing exactly what the apes are telling them to do. And this guy's kind of sneaking off and doing his own little thing. And this is why he's roaming around in the woods, pretty much. I mean, you know, and we're about to see that he's going to try and help these guys that just crash-landed. There's three of them. This one's dead. Either he's dead, or he's sleeping with his eyes open. Which, obviously not. I love how he can just automatically tell that whether they're alive or not by just putting his hand over their heart. Good luck getting that pulse. You're not going to get that pulse. So it's kind of ridiculous that he can do that. So it gets a little bit better. Right now it's kind of the series starts off, it's okay, it's not all that great. Once we start seeing these apes, the apes on horses and everything, and once they gain consciousness, it starts to get a little bit better. Right now it's not all that interesting, I guess. And here they come. It's the apes on horses. Obviously, that ape with the dog is like, there's something crash landed. And now they're all on their way over there.
What is it, Prefect?
I don't know.
Keep your guns ready.
So that's pretty much what it is. Based on that, you decide if you want to watch it or not. It's not all that great, but I still kind of enjoy watching it, even though it's even more inaccurate. It's really inaccurate, and it's technically worse than Tim Burton's Planet of the Apes, but I actually enjoyed watching this compared to Tim Burton's Planet of the Apes, so... So actually, I'm gonna try and skip ahead a little bit here, so you guys can see what it looks like a little bit further than... So let's see. So here we're taken to a scene where he's taken them to his, like, little secret hiding place.
No bones broke. I checked.
They just gained consciousness. The guy is out looking for food.
So do you. And you're probably just as far from them as he is.
And maybe not.
Come on, Alan. Take a look at this fruit. You ever see anything like this? And this place. You know what this looks like? A bomb shelter, maybe a couple hundred years old. Well, they didn't have bomb shelters on Earth a couple hundred years ago.
I know, Pete. Is our ship far from here?
No.
Can you take us there?
It wouldn't be safe dressed like that. But we could fool them. I'll go into Chelo and get different clothes for you. What's Chelo? Chelo? The village where humans are supposed to live. Well, I don't like the prefect. Well, I stay most of the time here. I found this place about 2 years ago. But I never told anybody about it. So you'll be safe here. Safe? From what?
From the apes, of course. Apes. Apes.
These two humans are strangers, and they are insane. Don't listen to them. Report their whereabouts to us at once if you should see them.
I was just thinking when I was a kid in Jersey City, couldn't even see the stars. Used to dream about them.
Just fast forward a little bit. Alright.
Yeah, well, we could have landed in a worse place, I'll tell you that.
Thank you.
It's the Planet of the Apes, that's what it is. So yeah, guys, that is the Planet of the Apes TV series. This concludes my unboxing of all Planet of the Apes movies, TV series, excluding Tim Burton's movie. I hope you enjoyed it. Like, comment, subscribe below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time for more unboxings and reviews. Till then, see ya.